perfectly sound.
Yeah.
I wish I was as large as Mr. Carbon. But I am not. So. Well, tall. Let's go with tall. Okay. I'm starting off on the right side. Hello. Can you hear me? Am I audible? Okay. Am I visible?
Hopefully.
No. Well, at least I'm partially mobile. So the reason I'm in town is actually we're getting set up for an event that's coming to Philadelphia on June 7th and 8th, but I don't want to talk about that now. I'll talk about it later. what I want to talk about now instead actually is this. This is my favorite product on Amazon. It's Tuscan whole milk, 1 gallon, 128 fluid ounces. The reason it is my favorite product on Amazon is because of the reviews. Reviews that look like this one. I know it's going to be hard to read, so I'll read this one to you. This is in the style of an entry from the J. Peterman catalog. And it says, "The sky in Pisa was blue that day, but the sort of blue one finds in only the hottest of flames. And even in the shadow of La Torre di Pisa, one could find no refuge. Although the Tuscan people naturally carry a skin tone far from a pasty British life, today the sun had baked them to a familiar Sicilian ground, a defense against its scorching rays, with which I, a simple traveler from New England, was not gifted. As the skin on my lips cracked and the darkest caverns of my mouth went dry, I reached into my warm leather rucksack and pulled out a gallon of ice-cold Tuscan whole milk. As I poured myself a short glass full, I marveled at its creamy consistency and swift, clean finish. Then I wondered why I packed my rucksack full of milk instead of water." This one here is actually one of my favorites. The very first time I read this to you, I know it's a little long, but it's great. It's in this theme of a romance novel called One Friday Without the Milk. "He always brought home milk on Friday. After a long, hard week full of days, he would burst through the door, his fatigue hidden behind a smile. There was a huge, icy jug of Tuscan whole milk, 1 gallon, 128 fluid ounces in his right hand. With his left hand, he would grip my waist. I was always cooking dinner, and press the cold frostiness of the jug against my arm as he kissed my cheek. I would jump, mostly to gratify him after a time, and smile lovingly at him. He was a good man, a wonderful husband, who always brought the milk on Friday. Tuscan whole milk, 1 gallon. Then there was that Friday, that terrible Friday that would ruin every Friday for the rest of my life. The door opened, but there was no buoyant greeting, no cold jug against the back of my arm. There was no Tuscan whole milk in his right hand, nor his left. There came no kiss. I watched as he sat down in the kitchen chair to remove his shoes. He wore no fatigue, but also no smile. I didn't speak, but turned back to the beans I had been stirring. I stirred until most of their little shriveled skins floated to the surface of the cloudy water. Something was wrong, but it was a vague wrongness that no amount of hard thought could give shape to. Over dinner that night, I casually inserted, 'What happened to the milk?' 'Oh,' he smiled sheepishly, glancing aside, 'I guess I forgot today.' That was when I knew. He was tired of this life with me, tired of bringing home the Tuscan whole milk, 1 gallon, 128 fluid ounces. He was probably shoveling funds into a secret bank account, looking at apartments in town, casting furtive glances at cashiers and secretaries and waitresses. That's when I knew it was over. Sometime later, he moved in with a cashier from the food mart down the street. And me? Well, I've gone soy." This is one in the classic style.